Hi guys, welcome to another episode of Learn Technology in 5 Minutes by Makeademy. This is Nidhi and I am a part of the instructor team at Makeademy. In this episode, we will learn about the device twin in Azure IoT. Before starting with device twin, let us take a glance at the Azure IoT Hub. Azure IoT Hub is a cloud-hosted service that helps establish secure communication between an IoT application and the device. Any device can be added to the IoT Hub as an IoT device. Several messaging protocols like MQTT, HTTP, etc. are used to transmit data from device to cloud and vice versa. Azure IoT Hub's capabilities allow us to build scalable and fully featured solutions for a variety of applications like managing industrial equipment, manufacturing, tracking, healthcare, monitoring, etc. Device twins in Azure IoT are JSON documents that store device state information, including configuration, metadata, and conditions. JSON is an open standard file format that contains human-readable text and stores values in attribute value pairs and array forms. In the device twin JSON document, all keys are UTF-8 encoded. Values can be of Boolean, number, string, object, or array type. Azure free trial account can be used for creating an IoT Hub and adding an IoT device to the IoT Hub. When an IoT device is added to the Azure IoT Hub, it automatically maintains a device twin for each added device. A device twin includes tags, desired properties, reported properties, and device identity properties. Let us understand these in brief one by one. Tags in device twin JSON documents are generally name value pairs. Tags can be read from or written to. Tags can also set notification of the change at the backend of an IoT application. Tags are only accessible by the backend and are not visible to device app. Desired properties are used to send state information to the device. Desired properties in device twin documents are used for synchronization and configuration purposes. The backend is authorized to set the desired properties and can also read them, whereas the device app can only read them. The backend can send notifications, and the device app can receive notification of changes in desired properties of the device twin. The device app sets reported properties. Reported properties are used to receive state information from the device. Reported properties, just like desired properties, are used for synchronization and configuration purposes. The device app is authorized to write and read the properties, whereas the backend can only read reported properties and query them. Device identity properties are the root of JSON documents and are read-only properties. Device identity properties are included in the device twin JSON document for the identification of IoT devices. Let us take an example to understand device twin JSON documents in depth. In this example document, the root object is the device identity properties like device ID, status, etc. The container objects in this JSON document are tags, desired properties, and reported properties. The container object contains some read-only elements like metadata, etag, and version, which are device twin metadata. This example document shows that the desired property is set by the backend with the desired configuration value. The device app is notified of this change immediately if connected. The reported property is set at the device app end. Reported properties are very useful where the backend wants to know the last value of any property for the query. IoT Hub maintains the timestamp of the last update in each JSON object of device twin for both desired and reported properties. The full desired property document is retrieved when an IoT device connects to the IoT Hub. The following flow must be ensured for full retrieval before the device gets disconnected. The device app connects to an IoT Hub. Device app subscribes for desired properties update notifications. The device app retrieves the full document for desired properties. Now we will see the use cases of Azure Device Twin. Store device-specific metadata in the cloud. For example, the deployment location of an IoT product. Report current state information, like available capabilities and conditions from the device app. Synchronization between device app and backend of an IoT application, like firmware version update, replacing desired properties, replace tags, partially update device twin, etc. by backend. Query your device metadata. Backend can query the device twin using SQL. Please visit the resources in this video description if you want to learn more and implement this Azure IoT service. That is all, folks. If you like this video, smash the subscribe button and ring the bell to be updated about our future video releases.